In the name of Allah, the most merciful and the most beneficent. Assalamu alaikum, everyone. Well, introduce myself. My name is Namrata Rupajwa. I'm department from BS Chemistry and my resource person is Dr. Hamad Muji. First of all, I'm thankful to my teacher, Dr. Hamad, that he gives me a chance to present my topic of sodium azide in front of you. Have a look at the table of contents. Sodium azide, solubility of common azide, uses of sodium azide, works of sodium azides, available toxicity data of common azides, health effects, immediate sign and symptoms of sodium azide warnings, how people can protect themselves, how sodium azide poisoning is treated. Well, we will discuss in sodium azide. A colorless salt, sodium azide is an inorganic chemical compound that can often be found in car airbags and many reagents or stock solutions used in healthcare facilities. When nearing its decomposition temperature, or when it comes into contact with some metals. Sodium azide can be particularly explosive, especially when it hasn't been flushed properly. When metals, for example, copper, brass, or lead, interact with sodium azide in place like drain pipes or on lab instruments, where the compound may be concentrated, explosions can certainly occur. They can also occur due to improper disposal or storage. Next, I want to explain solubility of common azides. First, sodium azide and its formula NaN3, then mole weight of it 65.01 and the solubility is 14.8. Second, potassium azide and formula it's KN3 and mole weight of 81.12, then solubility of 50.8. Third, silver azide and formula it's AgN3 and mole weight of it's 49.89, then solubility of 0.00793. Next, I discuss in uses of sodium azide in front of you. Step 1. Sodium azide is best known as a chemical found in automobile airbags. An electrical charge triggered by automobile impact causes sodium azide to explode and convert to nitrogen gas inside the airbag. Step 2. Sodium azide is used as a chemical preservative in hospitals and laboratories. Accidents have occurred in these settings. In one case, sodium azide was poured into a drain where it exploded and the toxic gas was inhaled. Step 3. Sodium azide is used in agriculture farming for pest control. Sodium azide is also used in detonators and other explosives. The works of sodium azide. The series of poisoning caused by sodium azide depends on the amount, route, and length of time of exposure, as well as the age and pre-existing medical condition of the person exposed. Breathing the gas that is formed from sodium azide causes the most harm, but ingesting, swallowing sodium azide can be toxic as well. The gas formed from sodium azide is most dangerous in enclosed places where the gas will be trapped. The toxic gas quickly disperses in open spaces, making it less harmful outdoors. The gas formed from sodium azide is less dense, lighter than air, so it will be rise. Sodium azide prevents the cells of the body from using oxygen. When this happens, the cells die. Sodium azide is more harmful to the heart and the brain than to other organs because the heart and the brain use a lot of oxygen. Next, I discuss in available toxicity data of common azides. Sodium azide and formaldehydes NaNO3, then toxicity 27 mg over kilogram. Next, ammonium azide and formaldehydes NH4 and 3, then toxicity very toxic. And the last one is barium azide Ba into N2 into 3, then toxicity toxic. Next, I discuss in health effects. Ingestion of even small concentration can be fatal. Mixing with water or acid creates too toxic hydrazoic gas. Contact with transition metals can lead to the formation of explosive shock sensitive metal azides. Immediate signs and symptoms of sodium azide exposure. People exposed to a small amount of sodium azide by breathing it, absorbing it through their skin or eating foods that contain it may have some or all of the following symptoms within minutes. Clear drainage from the nose, gas or dust exposure, cough gas or dust exposure. You look at this diagram, dizziness, nausea and vomiting, rapid breathing, rapid heart rate, and the last one is restlessness. Weakness, red eyes, gas or dust exposure, headache, skin burns and blisters, experience our direct skin contact. What is a large amount of sodium azide? Exposure to a large amount of sodium azide by any route may cause these other health effects as well. Showing these signs and symptoms does not necessarily mean that a person has been exposed to a sodium azide. Convulsions, low blood pressure, loss of consciousness, lung injury, respiratory failure leading to death, slow heart rate. Next, I explain the sodium azide warnings. Warning from the FDA, sodium azide solution potential for explosions from improper handling and disposal, August 5, 2015. Now, I discuss its 4 points. In front of you, handling, storage, disposal, sodium azide remediation. First, I discuss in sodium azide handling. The material safety data sheet and this SOP must be reviewed before of sodium azide in the laboratory. Do not use a metal spatula to weigh quantities of sodium azide. A ceramic spatula should be used. Use the minimum quantity of sodium azide possible. Turn gloves inside out while removing and tie off before disposal. Proper personal protective equipment. Second, I discuss in sodium azide storage. Do not store tubing or other materials that may have been in contact with solutions containing sodium azide. Collect sodium azide waste into a plastic reservoir and label the container with the proper name. Clearly, label all medical devices, collection containers, and waste disposal fixtures that use products containing sodium azide. Third, I discuss sodium azide disposal in front of you. Follow local, state, and federal regulations regarding handling and disposal of hazardous waste. Disposal of solutions per instrument and analyzer label instructions. Contain waste in plastic receptacles intended for hazardous materials as per material safety data sheet. Guidelines, the Clean Water Act allows disposal in sanitary sphere systems if the concentration is less than 1% of total annual wastewater from facility. Flush sodium azide solutions with the least 100-fold excess of water. Sodium azide lab pack waste. Have you looked to the diagram, which I discuss in next slide? listed waste is. Equately, as a dose material affects generator status. Large quantity generators listed waste 2.2 pounds per calendar month. Small quantity generator accumulate 2.2 pounds at any time. Conditionally exempt small quantity generator 2.2 pounds at any time. Whereas small quantity generator cannot accumulate any. And the last one I discuss in sodium azide remediation in front of you. National Institute for Computational Safety and Health and the Centers for Disease Control published decontamination procedures for azide contamination, plumbing, current intelligence, bulletin 30, explosive azide hazards, publication number 78, 127, August 16, 1976. Sodium azide remediation. Remediation involves isolating the plumbing, introducing a 10% sodium hydroxide solution and allowing it to soak in the isolated system for 60 hours. Sodium azide remediation. The solution is then collected and the sodium raised for a minimum of 50 minutes. Then next are nitrous acid solutions containing 20% acetic acid and 20% sodium nitrite is added to the system and allowed to soak for 24 hours. Then following another 50 minutes, flush with water and visual inspection, the plumbing is cleared for removal. We have looked at this diagram, sodium azide remediation waste. Then I explain in how people can protect themselves and what they should do if they are exposed to sodium azide. First, get fresh air by leaving the area where the sodium azide was released. Moving to an area with fresh air is a good way to reduce the possibility of death from exposure to sodium azide. If the sodium azide release was outside, move away from the area where the sodium azide was released. If the sodium azide release was indoors, get out of the building. If leaving the area that was exposed to sodium azide is not an option, stay as low to the ground as possible, because sodium azide fumes rise. If you are near a release of sodium azide, emergency coordination may tell you to either evacuate the area or to shelter in place inside a building to avoid being exposed to the chemical. From more information on evacuation during a chemical emergency, see facts about evacuation. For more information on sheltering in place during a chemical emergency, see facts about sheltering in place. If you think you have been exposed to sodium azide, you should remove your clothing rapidly, wash your entire body with soap and water, and get medical care as quickly as possible. Removing your clothing. Quickly take off clothing that may have sodium azide on it. Any clothing that has to be pulled over the head should be cut off the body instead of pulled over the head. If you're helping other people remove their clothing, try to avoid touching any contaminated areas and remove the clothing as quickly as possible. Then explain washing yourself. As quickly as possible, wash any sodium azide from your skin with large amount of soap and water. Washing with soap and water will help protect people from any chemical on their bodies. If your eyes are burning or your vision is blurred, rinse your eyes with plain water for 10 to 15 minutes. If you wear contact, remove them and put them with the contaminated clothing. Next, disposing of your clothes. After you have washed yourself, place your clothing inside a plastic bag. Avoid touching contaminated areas of clothing. If you can't avoid touching contaminated areas, you are sure where the contaminated areas are, wear rubber gloves or put the clothing in the bag using tongs, tool, handles, sticks or similar objects. When the local or state health department or emergency personnel arrive, tell them what you did with your cloth. The health department or emergency personnel will arrange for further disposal. Do not handle the plastic bag yourself. And the last one is how sodium azide poisoning is treated. Sodium azide poisoning is treated with supportive medical care in a hospital setting. No specific antidote exists for sodium azide poisoning. The most important thing is for victims to seek medical treatment as soon as possible. Have you any question about the topic? Then I will answer them. I hope you like my presentation. Thank you so much.